Hello everybody, good afternoon if you're in Singapore, in Malaysia, in this region, okay, and if you are everywhere else in the world, I want to wish you a good morning, a good evening, or even a good night, okay. This is Dr. Didi Mahmood coming to you live, okay, on a very, very, very exciting topic, isn't it? It's about weight management, about weight loss, about, you know, some of you want to weight gain perhaps, okay, but today we are going to concentrate a lot on weight loss, okay, because many questions has been going around here, yeah? And then after that, even, you know, as we go along in our life, you know, if you want to lose weight, okay, we lost that weight, and then after that, we get it back again, you know, in no time, okay, and you thought you lost it altogether, but somehow or other it creeps back in, right? So, okay, today we are going to address that, okay, but first of all, I want you to take a look at this question over here, and I want you to take a look at the question and answer the question. Okay, answer the question. Looking after your food or exercise, which one is harder? Okay, in terms of weight management. All right. Okay, everyone. Okay, I want you to take a look at this and then write down. Write it down. Write it down on the answers. All right, write it down on the answers. I want to read your answers right now, and then after that, I want to say hello to you guys. Okay.
I want you to take a look at this, and then write down.
I'm listening to myself talk, isn't it? Okay. All right. Are you there? Okay. Let's take a look. Let's take a look at who's on board right now. Okay. All right. Hang on. Very excited today. Okay, how are you guys? How are you guys? I know some of you are fasting, right? Okay. All right. So let's see who's over here right now. Yeah. Oh, okay. There's a couple of people here. All right. I will say hello, but you have to answer this first. Okay, you guys. Okay, I see many people over here, but I want you to answer all this. And maybe you write down, what is it? Why is it so hard to either look after your food or either to exercise? Okay, kenapa susah sangat eh? Mungkin kita nak jaga makan kita ke, ataupun kita nak bersenam. Yang mana paling susah dan kenapa? Okay, today Didi is going to talk to you in dual language. Okay, in English, in Malay, okay, and a spattering of Singlish. Bringing the current flavor, okay, the Singapore flavor to all over the world. Okay, everybody. Alright, I want you to tell me whether you hear me loud and clear, you see me loud and clear. Alright, you can see me? You can see me or not? All right, very good. Okay, very nice. Okay, so I want you to answer this first, and then after that, I want to look at who's behind the scene. Okay, hold it. Okay, just answer me first. Alright, okay, I'm looking pretty good, okay, then I can see behind the scene how I look like and all that, okay, how the whole thing is looking like. Alright, very nice, very nice. Okay, hang on. Okay, alrighty.
Alright, okay, I'm looking
pretty. I'm trying to switch off the I'm trying to off the sound. I'm trying to switch off the sound. Hang on, yeah. Okay, let me adjust this. Okay, very nice. Okay, so we can I can see how I how clear it is. All right, how clear it is that you are looking at the slides and also at me. Okay. All right. I want to say hello to, okay, Nora Hakim, Anissa Tamin, so many people. Sueli, hello. All right. Okay, Abang Jay lah, Abang Jahari bin Jadi. Okay, and then after that, we have Siti Rohani Aan. How are you? Siti Jamila is also watching. Yulianti. All right, and then after that, Haiza Zainal, hello. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Okay, from Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, around the region. Good morning, good evening, okay, and good night to everywhere else in the world, okay. This is a very, very special weight management session I'm going to share with you. So, I think very, very important is that we need to have the knowledge. Kita mesti ada ilmu. Kadang-kadang, kalau misalnya kita tak ada ilmu yang betul, itulah kadang-kadang kita kadang-kadang tersesat jalan. Tapi, walau macam mana pun, kalau ada ilmu, kalau kita sesat jalan, kita boleh balik ke pangkal jalan. Alright, so important is knowledge, okay? Whatever you do, the important thing is knowledge, and I'm very, very happy to be able to share it with you today, okay? But first of all, a few housekeeping duties that we need to do, okay? Number one, after you read this and then you answer this, right? Alright, after you read this and you answer this, hang on, huh? Okay. Alright, Okay, my name is Dr. Didi Mahmood. For some of you who this is the first time that you're looking at me, all right, I'm an exercise physiologist, also a nutritionist, and then I have many experience with many wonderful people out there doing Fat to Fit, Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, Asia, okay, and then even on RTM Television 1, okay, so I have helped many people. We have gone through the journey together on fat loss, okay, on weight loss, okay, the healthy way, but they have even lost up to 25 kilos within 3 months, okay, so it's not impossible. And okay, the nicest thing is that they end up very happy. All right, very happy. Why? Because they can eat 5 to 6 or 7 times a day, right? I know I said minimum 3 times. You can eat 5 times, or if you can afford to eat more, that's fine. Okay, I know some of you over here are the Fat to Fit cohorts, okay, which is really good. So please share with the rest of the viewers, okay, your weight loss journey and all that, you know, so to inspire all of us. Again, myself is also a work in progress, okay? I always believe we are always a work in progress, yeah? A work in progress, number one, okay? I think we need to get down to the very basic of, you know, what we are doing today, okay? About weight loss and all that, all right? So, okay, I don't want to, okay, another thing is that I want you to share this, very quickly share this on your Facebook, because sometimes, right, I think the first few times when we did it, when we did our exercise, I think it was lost halfway. So at least if you share it on your Facebook, at least you get it there, you know. So you and then the next time I'm going to give you homework as usual, okay, through my slides and all that. And then at least when you want to refer it again, you have it on your Facebook, okay. Kadang-kadang if you want to go through my Facebook, and then sometimes I've posted a lot of things, and then sometimes you have to search, and then it's all the way down, so cumbersome, yeah. So you share dekat you punya Facebook. And then of course we want everybody to be healthy lah. So if you want to share this with everybody else, with your families and friends and all that, go ahead and do it, okay? I will be more than happy, okay, that we are all in this together. Remember, we are in this together, and this is a journey, a very happy journey. I'll make sure of that, all right, with Dr. Didi, okay? All right, so everybody, I want you to look at this. We have the pot belly, okay? Don't know why lah, they call it the pot belly. Maybe there's pot inside lah kan? Ataupun worse come to worse, even beer belly. Ayo, you know, some people never drink beer, so got belly like that. Right, not? And then after that, here, okay? Look at this one here. Apa ini? Okay, they call it the turkey neck. Turkey neck. Alright, turkey neck. Macam-macam kesian turkey, eh? Kesian, ya? They call it the turkey neck, poor turkey, you know? So this is the one you double fold chins and all that. No, sometimes you know, we have double or triple fold, you know. And then this one, guess what? Okay, all right, write it down if you know. What is it? Okay, behind the arms. Okay, behind the arms. What is it? What is it, everybody? They call it bat wings. Okay, bat wings. Oh my gosh, you know, so they blame the turkey, they blame the bats, okay, macam-macam, kesian, kan? And then after that, you know, we have the pot belly and all that. No, those are the visual. If you see about being fat, about obese and all that, okay, that is the visual of it. Okay, I want all of you, okay, I think most, some of you know me, but maybe some of you are watching me for the first time. Okay, I'm very, very sensitive with the word obesity or gemuk or fat or tembam or semangat. Okay, because kenapa? Okay, I used to be obese before. I think some of you know, I used to be 90 kilograms before. And then after that, I was trying to fight. I lost my journey many times. You know, I put on more weight. I lose a little bit. Sometimes I put it double back on. And then the worst thing is that, you know, I had gastroenteritis. You know, I had, because I was, you know, the first thing when you think about losing weight, kan, when you nak turun berat badan, you selalu fikir, jangan makan banyak lah, kerana aku makan banyak lah, kerana itu gemuk. Jadi, a lot of people tak makan. So, when they tak makan, okay, for me, what happens to me is that I had ulcer. Okay, luka kat dalam perut. Okay, and then that's why I got gastroenteritis. Terrible, went to hospital and all that. No, so terrible. And then, worst thing, because also, kerana gemuk kan, and then after that, bila, you know, kadang-kadang orang cakap, alamak, tembam lah, macam semangat orang kau. Right, ataupun, you look very prosperous, okay, prosperity, progress, and for the nation, right, it's okay for the nation, but then it's too much prosperity and progress, not so good, not so good for health, okay, now, those are the things that we are, you know, and then another thing is that, you know, there's a, thunder, another one is what, thunder thighs, okay, sounds like one, you know, like superhero, thunder thighs, macam Thor gitu kan. Okay, now look at the thunder thighs, okay? Siapa yang kadang-kadang bila kita jalan, okay, I felt that as well. Okay, I felt that when kita jalan, kita macam melecit. Okay, dekat peha tu kita melecit. Kadang-kadang also, right, how many of you, right, when we put on weight, kadang-kadang when we even move, okay, we even brisk walk lah. Okay, brisk walk even. Or maybe just, Hari Raya or Chinese New Year or Deepavali, we wear nice, right? But then a lot of movement and all that. Then here also become, luka pula. Alright, you have abrasions and all that. And that's why you got to put some oil, right? Some baby oil, lotion and all that. Of course, for beauty, coconut oil, normally we put on our face to remove the makeup lah. But then here, we got to put at our, the thighs pula, kan? Okay, so again, alright, we try to lose that thunder thighs, that back wings, alright, that jaw, that neck, okay? Turkey neck, that pot belly, okay? Alright, how many of you, when you go on the scale, alright, how many of you when you go on the scale, this is how your scale looks like. Your weighing scale. Your weighing scale. Alright, look at that. Okay, Iza Zulfa, apa khabar? Kinsalam Mami Poji, is she watching? And Kinsalam Zubi as well. What's Zian? Zian, kucing dah bangun belum? Alright, your cat supposed to watch this with me, right? Okay, and then after that, let me see. Ifa Jufri, alright, nice to see you. How many of you the weight scale looks like that when you go on the scale? Alright, okay, either that or sometimes the scale cries. Or worst come to worst, you cry. Okay, or worst come to worst is your face over there. Alright, so the thing is that, okay, these are the things that, sometimes it becomes very, very stressful when we go up the scale, isn't it? And then sometimes like you at the end of it, you end up, okay, don't want to go up the scale because you don't want to see what is the numbers like. But, okay, that's not good. Okay, that's not good. Because if you don't watch it, if you don't tell yourself the reality, kalau kita tak nak bagi tahu kat diri kita, kita tak nak lah naik ke atas scale. Okay, kejap saya ambil scale. This is the scale. Okay, if you don't want to go on the scale, alright, that means nanti reality tau, you akan lupa reality. Nanti kadang-kadang you rasa, tak apalah, mungkin ringan sikit lah, mungkin tak apa. Sekali, tiba-tiba when you naik on the scale, berapa kilo tu eh. Kadang-kadang, okay, kadang-kadang ada sesiapa tak yang kat luar sana? How many of you, right? Okay, when I was obese, right? When I was morbidly obese, that is very, very big. How many of you have experienced this? You kind of put on weight. Right? You kind of put on weight. And then, after that, you look at the mirror, and then after that, you try to suck your tummy in a bit, and then after that, suddenly, you will end up like, wearing baggy clothes to hide it, and all that, right? Now, and then after that, after a while, you go on your scale, okay, kita timbang lah, selalu kita timbang kan, and then after that, at the end of it, like, you afraid to go on the scale, because every time the scale, the weight goes up. So, you don't want to be stressed, so, okay lah, today, you don't want to weigh. And then next year also, you don't want to weigh. Then after a while, right, you kind of like don't want to weigh. Alright, and then forget totally about it. And then after that, how many of you, right, suddenly, one morning you wake up and say, oh my gosh, what have I got myself into? How come I become like this? Suddenly, it feels like a sudden like that. But actually, all these things has been accumulated. That's why many of us, right, when we think like, alamak, we are very big, very, very fat, very obese. Must lose weight. Okay, I must lose weight very quickly because another 2 more weeks are Hari Raya already. So, I must lose 20 kilo. Alright, so another thing that I want to highlight to you guys to be kind to yourself. Remember, selalu, kalau misalnya kita nak turun berat badan tu, progress. Okay, whatever you lose very fast, it might not be healthy for you because you are, okay, stressing your body. Okay, alright, I'm going to go straight into that in a short while. Alright, now, remember, I nak you reset. Reset. Okay, today I'm going to help all of us. Okay, myself included, yourself included, we are in this together, we are a work in progress. Now, I want you to reset your mind. Whatever you have learned, whatever, okay, you have read or whatever you have believed, whatever you have practiced and you feel that it's just not working and then you're listening to Didi, okay, kerana nak dapatkan ilmu-ilmu yang mungkin boleh menolong, okay, dengan efektif. Okay, hari ini saya nak you tekan button reset. Tet! Okay, reset kenapa? Kita back to basics, okay, important. Okay, saya nak you tengok yang ini. Okay, remember tadi kita nak naik scale, takut. Okay, boleh naik scale macam ni. Jadi, dia ringan je. Okay? Alright. No, okay ah? Okay, everybody, I want you to start recording down your BMI, best body mass index. Body mass index. Alright? Kadar jisim tubuh. Alright? So, I want you to take your weight. Okay? Your weight. Weight in kilograms. Okay? Mungkin kita weigh besok pagi. Okay? Selepas pergi. Alright? After you have cleared your bowels. Okay? You go on your weighing scale. Take how many kilograms. And then after that, you divide by your height. How tall are you? Okay? Let's say you're very tall. Say 1.7 or 1.5 times 1.5. 1.7 times 1.7. Macam tu. Then lepas tu, you dah divide eh? Darab eh? Lepas tu, dapatkan angkanya. Okay? You get the numerals here. So, between 18.5 to 22.9. Now, if 18.5, if lower than 18.5 BMI, not very good because you are too thin. Okay, if you are too thin, okay, what will happen is that for the ladies, okay, for the ladies, alright, you will end up, creating a havoc in terms of your menstruation. Okay, in terms of your menstruation, alright, BMI lower than 18.5, okay, the danger is, okay, especially for teenagers, okay, kalau siapa-siapa ada anak dara, okay, anak-anak muda, okay, yang selalu kadang-kadang dia tak nak makan ataupun selaman banyak-banyak sangat ataupun really tak nak makan, jaga diet dan sebagainya, okay, kalau misalnya dia punya BMI kurang daripada 18.5, okay, itu tidak selamat, tidak selamat dan tidak sihat kerana nanti akan menjejas datangan haid. Okay, kedatangan haid mereka akan terjejas. Itu tak bagus. Okay, another thing is that if you're too thin, alright, your bone density, okay, your bone, okay, will be very brittle and all those kind of things, right? And then after you'll end up, you know, having fractures and stuff like that. So, it will affect the bone as well. Alright, so it will be within this range, tapi not more than 22.9, okay? Alright, another thing is that, okay, I want you to look at this. Okay, now, tengok ni. Tengok eh. Okay, ini. Tada! Okay, ni nak buat baju. Okay, ah, buat baju. Buat baju, ah, tailor. Okay, everyone, tailor, ah. Alright, I want you to take okay, kita kena dekatkan sedikit jadi dia nampak, ya. Alright, let me see. Ah, tu baru nampak tu. Okay, nampak, eh? Okay. Alright, I want you to take a look at the number, okay? Continue watching here. Alright, the man. Yang ini waist girth ni, maksud dia, okay, keliling pinggang kita. Okay, lelaki dan wanita. Mesti kurang daripada 102 cm dan gini eh. Okay, untuk orang lelaki yang lebih eh, yang lebih maksud dia boncit tau. Okay, kalau dia boncit, alright, for those of you men out there, alright, husband you all semua, your anak-anak, okay, your sons and all that, your brothers, okay, make sure that they have less than this, you know, in waist girth. That means the circumference of the waist. Because if they have more, that means they have like pot belly and stuff, okay, that will be, you know, higher risk of getting heart attack, okay, everyone, especially for the men. Please take note, yeah. Alright, for woman, waist hip ratio. Maksud dia, okay, you ambil, tengok eh, ini waist, yeah. Waist is not below the, you know, like bawah pusat eh. It's actually at the, macam kat sini kan, you punya waist kan. Okay. So, another thing is that your waist hip ratio. Alright, this one will be good for men and women to take as well. So, these are the numbers I want you to take, yeah. Alright, so, look at this everyone. See? Okay, ini nampak ya. Alright. How aging affects belt height. Tu dia. Bila kita muda-muda. Woohoo! Boleh nampak pusat lah. Okay, you can even put a belly ring over here. Woohoo! Okay, but then this one, okay, now okay lah. But then as you grow older, maybe 40s, 30s, there's some even in their 30s like that already, ya. And then after ini, adoy, dah macam Pak Ma'on lah. Okay, macam ni, sampai sini, oh. Alright, so this is also the cause of aging. Alright, everybody. Okay, so, everyone, okay? Alright, this is very, very unique, right? I love this one. That's why I love to share. See, youth, adult, middle age, and then old age. Kadang-kadang tak payah old age. Kadang-kadang 40s, 50s also, right? And then you will see like that already. Okay, so, remember, this is the one where the girth and circumference, yeah? The girth and circumference yang ini pakai ni, eh? Dia keliling gitu. Alright? This is like too much, that 102 for men, yeah? Centimeters. Alright. everybody, I want you, alright, to look at this. Okay. Alright, everyone. Look at this. Okay, first of all, back to basics. Kita kena tahu kenapa kita menjadi gemuk. Alright, these are a few of the things that I want to talk about. Alright. Okay, number one. Okay, it's over. Alright. Now, okay. Now, the number one is over or under eating. Okay, over or under eating. Okay, because you put on weight, kenapa? Kadang-kadang, okay, because you tak cukup makan. Alright. Because you don't have enough food, that's why you put on weight. You surprised, right? Normally, you think, alamak, it's over, you know, you overeat lah. Of course, obviously, overeat. Bila you makan lebih, terlalu lebih, dan kurang physical activity, kurang active, okay? That means if you eat a lot, overeating, and then you have little of movements and all that, physical activity, of course, you will put on weight. But again, also, if you undereat, if you don't have enough food in the body also, you tend to be overweight, you know why? Because the body doesn't want to burn, okay, in order to be in your ideal weight. It doesn't, it just want to stay that way because of the set point theory. Alright, now, okay, I'm going to tell you why, okay, physical, okay. I'm going to share with you this this one next. Okay, mana ni? Okay, wait. Okay, never mind. Later, I will talk in detail about overeating and undereating because that's the nutrition bit. So, always remember, cannot overeat, cannot also undereat. Must eat ngam-ngam. Okay? Alright, another thing is aging. Alright, aging also affects your health. Okay? Aging affects your health. Alright? So, again, alright, I want you to take a look at this. Okay? Take a look at this. Alright. Take a look at this. Okay? Alright. Just now was over and undereating and physical inactivity. That's why our government always asks us to be active, right? Okay, be active also has a good points. Later we talk about it. Now, aging also affects you. Now, as you grow in age, apart from looking like this, right? Okay, the thing is that it affects your hormones as well. Alright? Again, okay, I give you an example. Woman, alright? Ladies in their 50s or even 60s. Some people, okay, actually have menopause quite early. In their 40s, late 40s already got menopause. Or sometimes, alright? Okay. So, basically, as you age, your hormonal changes are there. Alright? So, again, like for women, maybe they, when they hit menopause, they tend to put on weight easily because of the lack, the lesser already for the lack of estrogen. See? So, those are the things that will affect you as you age. Yeah? And then again, okay, as you age also, you tend to lose a lot of lean body mass if you don't exercise. Right, if you don't exercise, and then you lose your lean body mass. Kalau tak senam, okay, jisim, otot-otot kita akan kehilangan. Okay, and then our bone also become less strong, right? Because if you don't exercise and all that, you know, you lose bone density mass, right? So, all these actually, when you have, a less lean body mass, ataupun you have less muscle cells in the body as you age, you know. And then, that's the reason why you tend to put on weight easily. Okay, senang nak gemuk. Kerana inilah faktor-faktornya. Eh? Faktor usia. Okay, faktor usia. Alright, so. Okay, lagi satu ialah. Okay, itu. Bila kita meningkat usia juga. Okay, kerana kita tidak bersenam. Because we, you know, we become less active, right? Okay, some people, right, if you notice, if they are active from young, they tend to be active when they are older. But if they used to be inactive when they're young, okay, if they change themselves to be active as they grow older, okay, they tend to be active as they grow older. Alright? Always remember when you hit the number 60, even 50 plus and 60s and all that, right? Sometimes, right, your decline in your punya functional fitness is very dramatic, no? Very steep. Cepat boleh turun. You see? So, it is very important to exercise. Not only for weight loss, but for performance as well. For your daily performance, okay? Alright. Then, I want to show you also, okay? And then also, okay, muscle mass yang tadi saya cakap, bila if you don't exercise, you lose your muscle. And that's where, you know, when you have lesser muscles, you tend to put on more fats. And that's where you tend to be obese, yeah? Lagi satu is gender. Okay, orang lelaki dia ada this hormone called testosterone all the way until 70s. Yeah, all the way. Tapi kita, because we are women, right? Our gender, you know, sometimes we tend to lose estrogen as we age, right? Especially when we hit menopause. Lagi satu is that gender pula, okay, for ladies, right? We are given, we are blessed with a lot of fats actually. That one is quite natural. You know why? Because if you notice, right, the woman, okay, has more fats around this region, okay, about around your pelvic area. Okay, you know why? Because, okay, naturally, biologically, okay, kita dipersiapkan untuk ada baby. Kerana itu kat situ banyak padding. Gitu kan? Lagi satu is that, okay, genes also, right? When we are talking about fats, right? I want to highlight to everybody, men and women, actually you must have essential fat in the body. Mesti ada, tak ada boleh apa tu, tak ada lemak langsung kat dalam badan tu, kerana lemak ni, okay, dia jadi cushion. Okay? Cushion nombor satu, apa? Cushion apa? Okay, jantung kita kan kat dalam apa tu, rib cage kita and all that lah kat dalam sini. Alright, now it is lined with a little bit of essential fats over there, jadi cushion. Alright, so can you imagine if your jantung, if your heart, and then also with your rib cage just there, and then after that when you move ah, it hits ah, wah, berdarah lah nanti kan. See, so it needs the cushion, yeah. Okay, so you see, so those are biologically, yeah. Okay, and then health conditions and medications, yeah. Okay, health condition and medication. Okay, tengok eh. Macam as we grow older, okay, sometimes or maybe even we look at our health conditions right now. How are you? How are you guys? Okay, apa khabar semua? Okay, maybe some of you are healthy. Yes, alhamdulillah. Okay, some of you mungkin has high blood pressure or diabetes. Okay, you see, diabetes, okay, like insulin resistance, right? Okay, the havoc, the haywire thing about insulin to the body, especially for diabetics. Okay, that one can also cause weight. Okay, weight gain. Okay, itu yang problemnya. Kadang-kadang nak turun badan pun susah. Yeah, tu satu. Lagi satu is that hypothyroid. As your thyroid functions, right, kadang-kadang dia breakdown. Ataupun some people are being born with, you know, low thyroid faculties, right? So, maksudnya kadang-kadang orang yang hypothyroid ni, kadang-kadang, apa tu, dia cepat gemuk. See? And then some of them, okay, with medication. Okay, like example, I'll give you an example lah. Endometriosis, okay, kadang-kadang they want to kill the cells, okay, yang growth tu. They give you medication, okay. Those medication kadang-kadang contains steroids, you know. Then some of the medication can make you grow fat, okay. Can make you put on weight, that is, easily, right. So again, okay, it doesn't mean that you must not take the medication. You must take the medication. Because your health condition is very important. Okay, always remember. Okay, I give you an example, yeah. Lagi satu, okay. Medication, okay. When we talk about health conditions and medication, we need to go back to basic. Okay, how are you? Right, how are you? Nanti I will talk about how are you, okay. But remember, medications you must take because it controls your penyakit. So, when you control your penyakit, alright, then all other things can get into gear. Okay, selalunya when our body, alright, listen to this everybody, okay, we are always so concerned about weight loss. Kita selalu nak turun berat badan. Kadang-kadang kita abaikan penyakit kita ataupun kesihatan kita, okay, ataupun penyakit kita yang kita sedia ada ni, kita tak important lah. Yang important sekali ialah turun berat badan, okay. People always concentrate on losing that weight, but they forget that the body, okay, the body punya survival instinct, eh. The body, number one is, it will always look after your health first. So, if your health tak betul, okay, your weight loss will become second important to the body. That's why most people cannot lose weight because they forget about their health. Alright, that's why no matter what you try, right, the body very, 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 very stubborn. Don't want to lose that weight because they want to concentrate. They want to concentrate their energy on making you healthier. Okay, always remember that, huh? So I want you to look at your health conditions and your medical conditions. If you're taking medication, please take your medication because it's important. It's your life. Alright, for those people who's taking all the medication, it stabilizes you punya health conditions. Okay, so you can be a little bit relatively healthy so that your body can concentrate on your weight loss. Okay, now another thing is that how you put on weight is very simple. Okay, you don't sleep. Alright, lack of sleep gives you cortisol. Alright, cortisol is a stress hormone in the body which will make you, okay, and then also if you lack of sleep also, if you lack of rest, If you're too high stress, high strung, okay, a lot of adrenaline pumping. Selalunya every day when you know, last time when you go to work, okay, it's like, oh, alamak, you know, nak terkeja-keja, you know, everything is like, oh, you know, got to catch that bus, got to, these are all stress. So accumulated stress become chronic, it gives you cortisol, and then also your hormone of leptin and ghrelin, which means that your hormone of hunger and satiety, eh. Maksudnya, inilah hormone yang membuat you rasa kenyang ataupun lapar, yang haywire kat dalam situ. Itu yang kadang-kadang, bila siapa yang pernah rasa, bila you tak tidur dengan cukup besok paginya, nanti you rasa macam nak makan benda-benda manis je. Betul ke tidak? Okay, jawab tu. Okay, everybody? Okay, so these are the important thing. We need to understand why we put on weight so that we can address that. Okay? Alright, good one. Okay, ya? Okay, first of all, okay, I nak tanya you, apa itu kesihatan? What is health? What is health, everybody? What is health? Okay, what is health? Okay, answer me, guys. Okay, ini Ifa Juri, you're still watching, that's good. Alah, Sueli, mau cry. I know, going on our weighing scale, right? I know Nora also. Nora said the weighing scale is a white elephant. I'm watching your ini eh, while you take a look at this. Alright, I'm watching okay, hi Terry. Alright, wow, Terry is all the way in London. Okay, what time is it right now, Terry? What time is it right now? Is it like early in the morning, right? Yeah, okay. Welcome, London people. Okay, all the walking footballers. Okay, a shout out to all IWFF walking footballers. Alright, and then, okay, I want you to take a look at this. Okay, what is health? I want you to answer that. Health, right, is not only, alright, like not falling sick, alright. Selalu kita ingat kesihatan tu ialah, okay, kita tak sakit dah, kita dah sihat lah. No, okay, health is actually all. Okay, it has to be mental health, okay, you need to be happy, you need to be calm, right. If let's say you stress, you know, alright, and then after that you go and gaduh with people, yeah, you go and fight with people. Alright, ataupun you don't want to wear your mask, you know. So very important, huh? So these are all things, and then cause people a lot of stress, you know. So these are all mental things, you know, mental things that affects your mind. And then also, okay, social, okay, you're not social, well, you know, your social well-being. You're always very angry with people, always want to gaduh with people and all that, you know. Then it has to be physical as well. You need to be healthy to do all the daily functions of life in a good way, right? Optimal, right? So if you notice, right, health is not only you're not sick or you don't have diseases or infirmity, okay? It's all this complete state of being. This is the definition by the World Health Organization since 1948 until today. Never change, This is really, really true, alright? Okay, so, everyone. So, as I said just now, right, you need to reset button, right? Okay, press it now. Press. Toot! Okay, Press, Okay, so now. Okay, remember, we have to reset our brain. Reset our heart. Sometimes, right, the brain and the heart doesn't connect. That's why your brain is logical. They tell you what to do. But then sometimes your heart don't want to do it. Because even in weight loss, right? Okay, our brain tells us, I'm very, very hungry. Oh my gosh. I'm so hungry. Very unhappy brain. Okay, I'm so hungry. And actually, it's true. It's true, right? You're very hungry. You can hear all these, you know, like growling. Okay, all the, you know, all the growling. Okay, all right. And then after that, your heart said, no, I don't want to eat lah. Wait, I'm fat. See? Alright. But again, there's also the brain that tells you, I'm hungry. But actually, you just ate a couple of minutes ago. You see? But your heart is telling you, I must listen to my brain, because I'm very hungry. So, which one? So we have to sync it together. Okay, everybody? But how to sync it together, guys? This magic word. Magic word. Commitment to health. Okay, guys. I want everyone to come back to basic, commitment to health. You see, Remember what I tell you just now? What I told you just now? Kalau you tak jaga kesihatan, first, your body takkan dengar kata-kata you untuk turunkan berat badan. If you do not listen to your body to look after your good health, your health to be good, okay, your body will not listen to you when you tell it to lose its weight. Alright? So, commitment to health. Now, another thing is that I don't want you to tell yourself that, okay, I've got to lose that weight. Just say you're committed to health. If you're committed to health, every single thing you do is for health. If you eat, is this for health? Is this good for health? Yes, it is. Then you eat it. You see? Right? You have less guilt. If you run, if you want to go and run or exercise, oh, actually, I malas lah. Okay, I very, very lazy to go and exercise. But if you tell yourself, hey, I'm committed to my health, man. You know, I need to take care of my health, alright? So, you see, you need to run because of that. Niat mesti betul. Kalau niat tak betul, kadang-kadang itulah yang ini, dia tak boleh sing. Okay? Niat mesti betul. Okay? Especially for those of us in Ramadan. Okay, this is, okay, selamat berpuasa semua orang. Okay, nak cakap selamat berbuka pula eh. Okay, selamat berpuasa semua orang. Okay, happy Ramadan. Okay, so this is the month where we actually sync those two together. Alright, as in all religion, we are given this, you know, our body as a duty, as our responsibility to take care of it so that we can perform in the optimal manner. Betul tak? Kita diberi badan ni, tubuh ni sebagai satu amanah oleh Allah, okay, supaya kita dapat menjaganya, supaya kita dapat melakukan, supaya kita dapat sihat, okay, bila menjaga kesihatan kita, kita dapat sihat, bila kita sihat, kita dapat melakukan segala-galanya dengan lebih baik lagi, amalan dengan lebih banyak lagi, kan, so kita mesti betul, see, commitment to health, okay, everybody, lose weight also commitment to health, because if you're committed to health, your weight loss will come into being, if you're committed to health, you start, you know, your body start being very healthy. See, so always committed to health. Alright, so three things, okay? Three things, this one always tripartite, they call it, eh? Three. Physical activity, exercise, nutrition, and how you think, how you feel. Alright? And then if you notice, right, all these things will give you health, not only health, your fitness, and with these two, it gives you your good performance, okay? So this is a very important, alright? Important thing, alright? So, look at this, everybody. When you have your health, your fitness, and then your performance, right? Health, fitness, performance, continuum, right? And then you notice that your chronological age, how old you are right now on the IC, on your birth cert, right? Okay, what's your age? And then, okay. And then you notice that but your biological age might be different. Okay, there might be people who's 40 years old, okay, or who's 50 years old, chronological age, okay, but who looks like they are in their 30s. Right, but there are people, all right, they are in their 20s, all right, they are in their 20s, and then they are in their 20s, but then you see the way they move, okay, very easy. You want to see how active a person is, one of the things you can watch is how they move. Do they move slowly? Is it very difficult for them to move? All right, again, all right, are they suffering from any injuries? All right, again, okay, that one will also affect the way they move. But are the injuries because of wear and tear? Or is it because they don't take care of their body? That's why, you know, they have all these pains and aches and all that. You see, so the way you move also represents how active you are. Right? If you're active, you notice that people move, you know, in a more active manner, right? So again, if you have medical conditions, right? Example, I'll give you an example. Like, you know, sometimes when we have diabetes, right? Or maybe even kidney. Sometimes our kidney fails when we have diabetes and hypertension and all that. And then you notice that, you know, you start having bengkak kat kaki, yeah, swelling legs, swelling joints and all that. And then you notice you tend to move slowly. You see, again, it comes back to health, alright? So everybody, and then again, you know, very easy to put on weight because, remember I was telling you, you know, your body is that way right now, alright? So what we're going to do right now is not only lose our weight, we want to look even younger, yeah? Okay, so next one. Okay, remember I was telling you about eating too little? Okay, we need to eat enough, okay? We need to eat enough, okay? Remember, I was telling you, we need to eat enough, alright? Some of you don't eat enough, okay? Some of you, okay, when you want to lose weight, you just go on a diet and you want to eat. You don't want to eat a lot. You just eat very little. And actually, that is why you put on weight. You cannot lose that weight and actually you put on more weight, alright? This is called the yo-yo diet. Okay, how many of you ever diet before? Okay, me, I put on my hand first. Okay, I know some of you diets, right, before. Now, if you ever go on a diet before, that's where you have already kacau, okay, disturb your metabolism. Because when you go on a diet, your metabolism goes very low. And once your metabolism goes very low, that's where it's easier for you to put on weight, alright? So look at this, everyone, okay? When you go on a diet, okay, your metabolism slows down, okay? It means that your body is giving signals up to the brain and say that the body is in dire, you know, emergency, no more food. So what it does is that it doesn't want to burn, you know, actively. It will burn very slowly, like all the folks, like people in the senior years, like people in the 70, 80 years old. Alright? So you notice, right? 70, 80 years old seniors are the normal ones, right? What they do is that they're very, very slow, right? Okay, I'm not talking about the ones that's very active, go marathon. I'm talking about the usual, you know, senior people yang they actually do little, okay, in terms of activity. So you notice they tend to move very slow, right? See, the body, you know, slows down the metabolism rate to that point that it doesn't want to burn, okay? It doesn't want to burn. So what happens that, okay, the more you go on a diet, the slower it burns, and then whatever you eat, it doesn't want to burn that calories and all that. It kind of stores it, okay? It kind of stores it for it to be used later, okay? Because right now it feels that, wow, you are in zaman darurat. You are in an emergency where there's no food ration, okay? And then you end of diet, oh, you're happy already lah, okay? So what happens is that when you go into normal eating, all right, that's where you have your weight gain, okay? That's where you see sluggish metabolism. So that's not what we want. Okay, everybody, I want you to eat very simple, okay? Let's get back to basic. Very simple. Every time you sit down, ask yourself, do you have these three components, macronutrients? Do you have your carbohydrates, complex carbohydrates, yeah? Wholemeal, whole grain, okay? Wholemeal spaghetti, okay? Wholemeal bread, brown rice, okay? Those things, yeah? All right? Do you have on your plate, okay? Or even noodles, okay? Okay? So, okay, yes, you have. Okay, when we're looking at our iftar also, look at what you have on your plate. Okay? And then you have your fruits and vegetables. Alright? You see, a whole part, a portion of it must be fruits and vegetables. Alright? And then after, do you have your fruits and vegetables? Do you have your meat alternative? This is your protein. Okay? Your protein. You need your protein for repair and recovery of your muscle cells. Alright? That means, in other words, you know, you need to recover from your exercise. You need to recover from your damaged cells and all that. Okay, for growth, okay, for children, okay, for you, for adolescents, they need it. Okay, so you need your meat and alternative. Very simple, I'm just going to give it to you. Okay, this one I've given it to you, complex carbohydrate. Okay, what happens to refined carbohydrates is that, okay, it gives you a high insulin surge. Okay, that's where, you know, if you eat too much, okay, sugar, the raw sugar, white sugar and all that, okay, things that contains a lot of sugar, it will whack, okay, it will whack your insulin. Until to the point that it cannot function properly, okay? That's where sometimes, you know, you end up with having diabetes problem and all that, huh? All right, insulin insensitivity, that's what they call it, okay? And then again, all right, these three are very important. Okay, but why? Because if you eat, if you look at your plate this way, all right, whatever you put on your plate, even with, you know, and then they say use healthy oils. Olive oil is good, right? Choose your water, okay? Plain water is really good. Plain water, zero calories, okay? So you need to drink it. Okay, there's no such thing as gemuk air, alright, buncit air, alright? Yang buncit tu selamanya lemak, okay? Bukan buncit air, okay? So everybody, and then after that, okay, your milk and all that, okay? Your calcium and everything, okay? So if you notice, right, all this, if you have enough of these three components on your plate, alright, that means you have your vitamins, your minerals in there, you see? So, alright, I know a lot of you are taking your vitamin pills and all that. That's fine. But always remember, basic, have your proper food full of vitamins and minerals. Okay? So, alright, do that way. Okay, everybody? Alright, so very simple. Okay, this one, if you're thinking of losing weight and all that, very easy. The breast of a chicken. Okay, dada ayam. Okay, dada ayam is good. Okay, anything white meat. Okay, white meat. Okay, fish. Okay, salmon, those kind of things, sardines, tuna, okay, ikan-ikan semua, good, alright, very easy, alright, meat, red meat, okay, you have to be very careful, it has to be lean meat, kalau tidak, no, all the white things, okay, a lot of fatty things in there, yeah, okay, turkey is really good, okay, very good protein in there, alright, so everybody, if you're celebrating Christmas, Turkey is a good time pula. Okay, Christmas is a good time to eat turkey. But again, turkey can be eaten in any other days. Alright? Right, everyone? Okay, so everyone. Okay, see? Egg. Okay, these are the magic food in weight loss. Okay, I want you to take a look at this first. Alright, take a look at this first. Alright? I want to say hello to everybody else. Okay? Okay, to everybody who's watching right now. Alright, Aniza, Captain Calories ni, Aniza Lazim, alright, Okay, lagi satu. Safi Abdul Ghani. How are you, girl? Okay, Wawa. Lah kan. Wow, over and under eating. Correct, right? Okay, that's true, isn't it? Okay, everyone. That's really good. Okay, and then after we go into... Okay, this is the magic food. Okay, magic food. Okay, magic food ni... Okay, this one. Okay, how to lose weight. Eat your eggs. A lot of people cakap, okay, yellow tak bagus lah, apalah, cholesterol and everything, right? Never mind. Eat your eggs. Eat it daily. Alright, if you're afraid of your cholesterol or whatever, okay, eat it on alternative days. Right, but this is really good. Have it during your breakfast. Research, many researchers have shown that if you eat eggs in the morning, alright, you tend to eat lesser calories, you tend to eat healthily the whole day long. You know that? That's what they say. Okay, and never miss breakfast. So you need to eat 3 to 5 times. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, and then after that, your snacks, yeah? And then after that, green tea. Green tea is really good, okay? Now, I want to give you beauty tips as well, right? Okay, green tea is very good. It contains antioxidants and all that for your weight loss. This one, okay, this one and this one and this one are all beauty foods as well, okay? Now, how many glasses of water that you need to drink per day? 8 to 12 glasses, or at least that 2.5 liters or 2 liters, yeah? Alright, white water or rather plain water lah. Okay, this one, what is beauty about it? Okay, when you actually break it, take the white color, kind of the white egg, okay, and then put it on your face, it becomes your mask. For beauty. There's satu this one, right? When you have the teh uncang kan, alright, the tea bag, alright, when you want to, after you finish your drinking your tea, put it inside, like your Tupperware or something, put it inside the fridge, then at night before you go to bed, put it here. So after you go and sleep with that. Okay, so it becomes refreshing to your eyes. It takes away the eye bags, you know. It makes your eyes very fresh. Alright, lagi satu is that water. Okay, if you drink water, you notice that you have lesser of jerawat, you know, your oily face or oily hair and stuff. Okay, so this is really good. And of course, if you have dry skin, it's not very good. Alright, it looks awful. And also, it's not very good for those of you who's diabetics. Okay, everybody. Because remember, they always say to take care of your skin, your legs. It's not only your feet, no, to take care. Your whole body, you have to make sure that it's not dry. Because if it's dry, you tend to have cut. Alright, when you have cut, kalau misalnya kita ada diabetes kan, kita tak minum banyak air dan sebagainya, kadang-kadang ada luka, nanti dari situlah ada infection, ya. Ada kuman-kuman masuk dan sebagainya. So this can become your beauty food as well. Alright, so again, this one, everybody, take a look at this. This is your next food. That's really, really good. Take a look at this. Eh, Nomaria, apa khabar? Kan, apa khabar ni? You guys are talking about the weighing scale lah. Okay, got nightmares and everything, man. Okay, alright. So, everybody, okay, these are your magic food. Okay, your magic food also. Okay, why? Okay, look at this. Granola, oats. Okay, this is your magic food for weight loss. Okay, everyone. Okay, why? Because it contains lots of fiber. Now, fiber makes you, number one, if you are looking to make yourself full, so you don't tend to eat over, lah, overeating, kan? You have a lot of fiber in your granola, in your bran, in your muesli, right? And then in your kukus. And then after that, also in your brown rice. And then after in your oats, kan? Those are really good food. And then also for those of you with high cholesterol, hypertension, and then diabetes, right? Okay, eat high fiber food. Alright, high fiber food. It makes you full. And then it also, okay, helps in turunkan, you punya cholesterol level, ya? Alright, so your nut butter, peanut butter, okay? So these are all peanut butter, nuts and all that. These are all very rich in protein, okay? Very important. See, your olive oil, your shredded coconut, see? Your honey, alright? And this one needs to be real honey, ya? Cannot be a lot of watery honey, banyak sugar inside. Your dark chocolate is good, alright? So we still can have our dark chocolate. That's why, you see, if you go to hotels, right? Sometimes they put dark chocolate on your pillow, right? For you to, you know, feel happy lah, you eat your dark chocolate and all. It has weight loss properties as well. And your avocado is good fat, yeah? So we need good fat like this. And then also omega-3, omega-6, you know, from your fish. Okay, from your sardines, from your tuna and all that, okay? And your salmon and everything. So these are all your weight loss food, okay? Have more of this, okay? That would be really, really good, okay? For you to maintain your health. Alright. So again, everybody, must eat. Do not eat. Alright? And then you eat food. Do not drink only, okay? What I mean by this is this. When you eat, I want you to eat food where you chew them. Alright? Some of you are drinking only meal replacement. That means you don't eat your meal, you only drink fluid. Alright, that you know, that you put with shake or whatever. I want you to eat real food. Wholesome real food. Because that's where, okay, let me tell you, okay, if you even eat your meal replacements, okay, meal replacements also has number of calories inside there. Okay, wouldn't it be nice if you have that same number of calories in the proper food that you eat, that you chew, you know? Because again, our brain, okay, needs to chew things. If it doesn't chew, it will always feel that it's hungry. Okay, so always remember. So again, lesson 2, may your plate be with nutrients and health food. Remember, tadi kita cakap pasal pasal plate kan? Kita punya pinggan tu mesti penuh dengan benda-benda yang menyihatkan lah. Kalau, ya? Lagi satu is that, okay, for those of you who is on puasa, right? Puasa Ramadan. Okay, some of you will say, alah, so now no need to worry lah because Ramadan, what, we don't eat a lot and all that, right? Okay, actually guys, saya nak ingatkan, okay, for those of you who's fasting, it's not a matter of eating a lot or eating less during Ramadan. You have to eat well during Ramadan. Okay, you know, we are not encouraged to not eat well during Ramadan. Alright, now, if you want to change your habits of eating during Ramadan, okay, Ramadan and normal days actually is the same. It's just that Ramadan, we don't eat at a certain time. So, this is how I want you to do it so that your body, alright, when during Ramadan, I know some of you, many of you lah, okay, myself included, okay, because I have a lot of weight loss issues as well, right, because I have genes, right, especially if you have genes, you know, people who was your mom, your dad, you know, your lineage is fat, you know, obese and all that, you tend to have the fat genes as well easily. Now, for those of you, right, your puasa, okay, we and then especially with you know, low metabolism rate, who puts on weight very easily, who has genes, genetic with obesity genes. Alright, now this is it. Kadang-kadang when you puasa, right, you notice, wow, you lose weight. After when you raya, you start putting on double the weight back. Right? You notice? That's why when you buat baju sebelum puasa, alright, semua okay, kecil-kecilkan baju. Tapi lepas tu pagi raya nak, okay, pagi raya still mungkin okay kot. So, mungkin 2-3 days after that, you start noticing that, wah, alamak, cannot lah, senak lah, macam tu, tak boleh, itu nak kena tak nafas. See? So, you know why? Because remember I was telling you just now, when you go on a diet, when you eat very little, alright, your body goes into this thing where it slows down the metabolism rate. Okay, that's what happens to us when we puasa if you don't eat enough. So, you have to eat 1,500 to 1,800 calories depending on how active you are. Ladies, if you want to lose weight, 1,500 or even 1,300 to 1,500, that's fine. Okay? Now for men, alright, 2,400 calories. Keep it consistent, whether you puasa or you're not. Okay, it's just that during puasa, okay, it's actually the same. During puasa, pagi, when you makan pagi tu kan, it's actually you punya sarapan. Betul tak? See? When you makan, when you berbuka puasa, that is your, basically, your lunch and your dinner lah after that. Because you eat three times, apa? You makan, okay, makan apa tu, dates and everything, a little bit, and then after that, you drink water, you go solat, after that, you makan some more, right? So, actually, you eat three times already. So, let's keep to that three times, or even five times, that's fine, or four times, or five times, that's fine. Eat little at regular intervals. So, your body is always, okay, high in terms of alertness, and then in terms of energy, okay? Once your energy drops, that's where the body goes into haywire, okay? So, remember, another thing is that chew macam mana? Okay, number one, you need to chew. Okay, 25 times, 40 times, okay, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, okay, chew at least 40 times, okay, why? Because your digestion starts in your mouth, and then once you chew properly up here, it helps your here, okay, to relax and then go into its digestion mode. Okay, that's why a lot of people during Ramadan, during puasa, they have a lot of stomach upset because they eat too fast, they don't chew enough, okay, everybody? Alright, everybody, Just keep this one. I like to show. This is one of the things that I always use for my fat to fit. All right. You if you want to watch how you eat. All right. So go ahead and write into your journal. Okay. Because if you write in your journal, then you know how you eat. Okay. Where you eat, how you eat. You know. And then after that, you know. And then you notice that I put height, weight, and chest and all that. Right. This is a good one to follow. Okay. And then your activities as well. Alright, and then your breakfast, how much you eat, how little you eat, you know, so at least you know, alright? Okay, All right, everybody. Can you see? I think you can't see. You got to go a little bit nearer. Okay. Ah, Siti Rosmina Jaafar. Cik Siti. Cik Siti kita. Okay. Nak dekat Raya ni. Nanti dengar. Oh, sekarang dah dengar lah lagu-lagu Cik Siti. Yang apa tu? Raya tu kan? Yang lagu Raya tu. Yang itu my favorite tu. Duhai Bunda. Kan? Kita kan? Lagu dia. Sedap tu. Okay. Nur Mariam. Abang Jari. Ah, coffee. Abang Jari say coffee. Coffee is a good weight loss mechanism tau. Okay? Alright. Come. Okay. Now, everyone. Okay. Look at this. Very simple. I want you to list your triggers. With having that journal, right? Then you will have your trigger point tau. Apa? Is it because you eating? Nanti kan bila kita dah buka CB and PKP kan? Alright. When we open, you know, when we don't stay at home very much, you know, once the COVID-19 is over. Alright, then you will notice if you have all these journal, you will notice that you tend to eat more with certain people, or maybe is it because you eat because you're in front of the television all the time? So these are the list and your trigger, and then you solve it. Alright, okay, everybody. Okay, now another thing I want to highlight is this, young guys. Okay, binging and mood eating. Alright, another thing is amnesia calories. If you watch TV while you're eating, sometimes you don't tend to be mindful of what you eat. Alright? This is what I always try to practice. You know, this is what I always try to practice. You know, when we have a plate of food, you know, of course we have to say thanks, right? Say grace, alhamdulillah, you know, now that kita puasa, you know, we tend to appreciate our food much, much better, isn't it? So what I do is that I look at the food, you know, I see the texture, I feel the texture, I smell it. You see, these are all the things that you appreciate the food, and that's how, okay, you will end up appreciating the food. And then when you eat, you tend to be mindful of it, okay? So that's your, you know, and then it always takes 21 days to form a habit. So start today, all right? Start today, okay? And then again, okay, later, okay, after we finish this, right, I'm going to put a link about are you eating your mood. Sometimes when you eat, it's not because you're hungry. It is because you're sad, you're upset, you bosan, okay, you bored or whatever, you know. So I'm going to put a link in the one that I'm going to share later, right? In our weight loss, right? Our weight loss and weight management. So later I'm just going to add a link, and I also guide to healthy hydration. I told you just now to drink 8 to 12 glasses, all right? And then how to drink during bulan puasa ini, okay? It will be in my link to the guide to the healthy hydration. Okay, everybody. All right. So later we. You share. Okay, now, going back to the next one, which is very simple and very important. Okay, revising again, physical activity, nutrition, psychology, these three is needed so that we can look after our health. And then if we do all these things in tandem, hand in hand, you'll notice that you will improve your fitness and then your performance. Now, remember, nutrition, okay, come. Okay, why do we need to? Okay, just now I was talking about nutrition for weight loss, right? But again, why do we need to exercise anyway? Look at this. Okay, some people, they just watch their food. They go on a diet. They don't want to exercise. And then you will hear some people saying that, oh, actually, no need to exercise. Actually, about 90% or 80% is just food. Okay, and then only 20% of what is exercise. So exercise is not important. Actually, okay, that one is not true, okay, guys? Okay, this is what happens if you don't exercise and you just, you know, just lose your weight through dieting only. Okay, now, this is called skin elasticity. Okay, your body, you know, when we gemuk, right, it takes time to gemuk. When we are fat, it takes time to be fat, right? So, if you look after, go into an extreme diet, all right, you eat very little, less than 500 calories a day or whatever, it's going to be damaging not only to your body, it's going to be damaging to how it looks as well, the skin elasticity. The skin elasticity doesn't have enough time to get down to size, you see? So that's what happened. Alright? So remember, when you have liposuction, right? Liposuction, they take out the fat. Now, this is what happened. So, very ugly as well. And then sometimes you have cellulites and everything, right? So again, if you want to have weight loss in the nicest manner, the healthiest manner, alright? Do your exercise as well as looking after your food and then managing your stress, okay? That means you have enough sleep and manage your stress. Now, remember, alright guys, okay, this is, I'm going to tell you what is, okay, even one bout of exercise, okay, I don't know whether you can see this, but it's okay, come and look at me, alright, Even one bout of exercise, yang orang yang tak pernah exercise, if let's say you have not exercised before, right? Even one bout of exercise, one time of exercise, one time only. Okay, let's say you do a 10 minutes of exercise or 20 minutes of exercise, one time. Okay, you will notice that you will feel really good. Okay, why? Okay, you will not regret it. Okay, how many of you say, I don't want to exercise, I'm malas. But then if you force yourself, okay, to exercise, even 5 minutes, at the end of it, how many of you say, oh, I regret exercise? Never, right? That's because your endorphins is talking to you. That's the hormones that makes you feel happy. Okay, that's your endorphins. Alright? So that's the one that we want. Okay, and that's the one that gives us a lot of confidence, a lot of healthy and self-esteem as well. Okay, everybody. And then not only that, okay, if you exercise, okay, your bone and density will increase. Alright? Everybody, okay, answer me. What else can you achieve by exercising? Okay, higher metabolic efficiency as well. Remember just now, when you diet, you need to exercise. Because once you diet, your metabolism goes down. You need to exercise, especially carry weight, okay, in order for you to build up the metabolic efficiency, okay, metabolism rate. Okay, and then decrease body fat, of course. Okay, you notice, fats take a lot of space. But then, if let's say you do exercise, alright, you do exercise as well, you notice that your body tends to be smaller, and then it's more mantap. Okay, more mantap. Solid lah, kata orang tu eh. Right, dia tak menggelebi. You know, something like that, yeah. Okay, everybody, and again, alright. Very easy. Nutrition, okay, when we are looking after our weight. Some people say, okay lah, we look after our weight, and then after that, we lose weight lah, kan? Okay, we look after our food, then we lose weight. That's it, no need to exercise. But you're going to miss out on a lot, no? Only, okay, let's say I ask you, can you get your strength by just eating? No. Even bodybuilders needs to exercise even though they are taking their protein. See? Okay, can you be flexible if you just eat? No. If you have not exercised at all and if you have not stretched, you will notice that, okay, a lot of your areas are become very not flexible. And that's where you will get a lot of injuries, yeah? Alright, see? Okay, if you exercise, your body composition, okay, your weight, your fats in the body, your water level in your body, your bones, you know, all will be healthier. And then you notice that, okay, cardiovascular endurance. Okay, cardiovascular endurance is that when you exercise, you notice that you tak lelah, you tak penat, you got more energy. You see, can you get that from just, okay, if you notice, right, there are many people out there who is not well, okay, they have high blood pressure or they have diabetes and all that, they refuse to exercise. But you notice how tired they are all the time, alright, and then they cannot even, you know, they don't even have the energy to actually move and do their normal daily routine, see? So all this, you cannot get by eating pills or by just eating your food and then hope that you're going to be fit. No, you need to exercise. And exercise also, number one, makes you younger, makes you happier, right? So, remember I was telling you that you will be healthier and younger when you exercise? Okay, come, look at this, everyone. I want you to take a look at that. I'm going to see and say, Yuli, hello Yuli. Okay, Mazza, apa khabar Mazza? Assalamualaikum Mazza. Selamat berpuasa. Okay, a little bit more guys, okay? Alright, how much physical activity is needed? Alright, the WHO, World Health Organization and the American College of Sports Medicine has mentioned that, okay, as a guideline, they mentioned that you need 150 minutes, okay, 150 minutes seminggu, alright, a week for you to exercise. And or 75 minutes of high intensity exercise or 150 minutes of low moderate intensity exercise, yeah? Okay, jadi you need to exercise like that. Okay, again, one question is this, okay, you can, that means in other words, you need to exercise about 30 minutes or so, right? So if you need to exercise 30 minutes, does it mean that one sekelompok 30 minutes? No, you can actually break it out. You can do 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes in the afternoon, 10 minutes at night, okay? So again, alright, so again, you need your cardiovascular exercise in order for you to drop down in size. If you're fat, if you're obese, we need that cardiovascular intensity to bring down our size. Okay, that means you need to either run or brisk walking, okay, do aerobics, do your dance and all that, right? Okay, another thing is that you need to carry weight. You need to do stretch band or exercise or medicine ball or apa tu, dumbbells, right? Or even household materials, right? Where you angkat berat, right? Those are needed for strength and endurance, right? Now why? Because that one also will give you the shape you need when you lose your weight, right? And then also it helps you to burn more calories. Now, if you have more muscles in the body, when you do weights and all that, you have more muscle. When you exercise, okay, you build muscle mass. When you have more muscles in the body, your muscle cells burn 3 times more calories just by being there as compared to your fat cells. Now, your fat cells, dia tak berfungsi. Dia cuma gemuk saja dekat situ aja, dia happy-happy. Tetapi, your muscle cells dekat situ, dia kerja keras. Okay? Alright, so we need to have more muscle cells. Okay? Muscle cells is the one yang kerja keras. Okay? Fat cells is the one yang lepak saja. That's why, when you have more fat cells, you tend to be lepak saja. So, the more lepak you become, the more lepak gemuk we become. Okay? Alright, everybody? And then, the more lepak gemuk we become, it affects all our organs. Alright? Then, our organs starts having insulin insensitivity. Now, when your body is really big, okay, your heart, okay, want to pump blood to the rest of you punya sini, alright, rest of your body, but your body is big, okay. Let's say I'm very thin, right? Right now, I'm slimmer right now. But then if my heart wants to, you know, sends blood through the blood vessels to here, okay, it doesn't take too much work. But if I'm very big and I'm very fat, okay, my heart will have to pump extra, okay, to pump, okay, the same 5 liter of blood into all my body. Itu yang kadang-kadang dia nak breakdown tu. Itu yang kadang-kadang, alright, because it works so hard, that's where we have, you know, sometimes our blood vessels give a lot of problems to us. So that's why we have heart problems. So that's why we have high blood pressure, you know. So that's the thing, okay. So everybody, always remember, yeah. So, remember what I say, okay. You need to, you know, when we exercise, reminder tomorrow at 3 p.m. Okay, we have exercise for weight loss, okay, everybody. And also exercise to be healthy, to increase our immunity tomorrow at 3 o'clock. Okay, it's always very fun because we have a lot of laughter. Alright, so again, okay, when we exercise, these are the main thing that you need to do, okay. Your core strength, which we will do. Okay, core strength is here. Okay, tomorrow I will explain more. We need to know our strength, our endurance, our flexibility, and then our focus, okay, alright. Okay. Of course, I must highlight to you, you know, in terms of CB, eh? CB, PKP, okay, masa-masa kita apa tu, kata orang tu, masa stay at home, eh? Nowadays when we stay at home, alright, I will not encourage you to do high intensity exercise. High intensity, eh? Bahasa macam lidah terkeluar, like, you know, high intensity exercise, because that will be quite damaging actually, alright, it will be damaging to the upper respiratory tract, okay, come and take a look at this, okay. Take a look at this. I want you to come closer and make sure that you can see very close. Alright? Okay, can you see here? Alright? So, you notice that, okay, the risk of upper respiratory infections, right? Okay, you can come closer. Alright, risk of upper respiratory infection, tract infection is up there. And this is the amount and intensity of exercise. Now, this is the J curve, whereby you need to exercise moderately at this point of time. Okay, because you're at home and all that, right? Do not exercise too over. Okay, maksudnya high intensity, where like when you do exercise, like you cannot breathe and stuff like that, right? Where you cannot even, you know, string a couple of words together, that is very high intensity. That will be quite damaging because it will increase your risk of upper respiratory tract, as in, you know, COVID-19 and all that, okay? So we need to also exercise for immunity, all right? And in order to exercise for immunity, alright, everybody, we need to exercise in a moderate, not high, but in a moderate, okay? And for those of you sedentary, you need to exercise as well, alright? You need to exercise as well because your risk, okay? Your risk, you notice that? This is your risk of, okay, this is you sedentary, not doing any exercise, okay? No physical activity, not active at all, Here is, okay, look down a little bit here, okay? I need to show you, okay, Alright, so here, okay, can you see it? Okay, tilt it, yeah? Okay, so again, everybody, sedentary, yeah? If you are sedentary, rather inactive at this point of time, alright, or rather sedentary, tak selalu exercise, you know? So, and then this is the moderate, okay, moderate people, okay, you see, you notice? If you don't exercise, your risk is higher. Okay, for upper respiratory tract. If you exercise moderately, alright, not too high, right, your risk is a little bit lower. But if you exercise very high intensity exercise, your risk goes up. Okay, that's how you read the ini, yeah. Okay, so next one, yeah. Okay, everybody. Okay, always remember. Okay, this is the goals and process. Process and progress. Selalu we always think about. Okay, losing weight, losing weight, losing weight. If I don't lose weight, if I don't lose 1 kilogram today, that means I'm a failure. No. Alright. If you think like that, your brain becomes more stubborn. Okay, and it doesn't want to help you lose that weight. Okay, I want you to write your objective. This one is good, yeah. Can you see it? Is it very clear? Okay, here actually nothing, it's empty here. I just want you to take a look at this, okay? So this is your process and progress. Okay, open up a journal, everybody. Write your objective today, okay? Write your objective today. I will ask about it tomorrow, yeah? What is your objective, okay? And then what's your situations, what's your issues, what's your challenges? Okay, apa yang mencabar? Okay, apa situasi you all? Okay, kat sini tulis apa objective, okay? Apa matlamat dia? Okay, you all nak turunkan berat badan kerana apa? Macam tu, eh? And then, okay, ini you kena bagi yourself time lah. Bila you nak lose that weight until, kalau you ada 10 kilogram weight, nak lose bila? Okay, you got to be realistic, yeah? Can you see me here? Okay, come here. Okay, you have to be realistic, everybody. In order for the body to function well, okay, dengar, eh? In order for the body to function well, okay, you, the healthy weight to lose is about 0.5 to 1 kilo. In a week, okay, that is healthy weight loss. All right, very easy. Okay, don't worry about 10 kilo. Worry about your 500 gram first. Okay, if you can lose your 500 gram in no time, you will lose that 10 kilo. Okay, selalunya people jump the gun. They always think of that 10 kilo. Okay, for me, okay, to tell my brain that something achievable. Okay, 500 gram ataupun 1 kilo. That's fine. Okay, that's easy to lose slowly but surely, okay? And then also, it's your body way of adjusting so that you don't have that menglebi. And it's also your body way of not falling sick. How many of you, when you try to lose weight, okay, the quicker way, the diet way, the emergency way, you end up with a lot of flu and fever and all that, right? See, so we do not want our body to lose our immunity as well. We want to be healthy while we lose weight. And if we are healthy when we lose weight, senang lah, we lose weight some more. But if you, let's say you do extreme dieting, or you exercise like crazy, or you don't follow whatever I asked you, right, just now, right, in a nice way like that, okay, in a systematic way, and then after you start getting sick, okay, initially you lost, say, maybe the 1 kilo, but when you get sick, you can't do anything, right? Remember, don't exercise when you get sick, and then after that, you tend not to do anything, and then at the end of it, well, you lose, you know, that achievement that you've already got, okay? So remember, okay, long-term planning, okay? Everybody, okay? Okay, ni dah. Okay, yeah. So again, everyone. Okay, I am going to have one sharing with you regarding de-stress and stress management and beauty. Okay, one more. Right, I think that week before, on Tuesday and on that last week before we go into Raya. Okay, I'm going to talk about de-stress, sleep, breathing, R&R, positive reaffirmation, and then beauty. Okay, that one is going to be next. Nanti I will announce it. Okay, that one will be very good because I'm going to put a lot of beauty tips because we are the next few days will be Raya already. Okay, so don't miss that one. We need a lot of de-stress and beauty. Okay, at that point of time. All right. So all right. So everybody, okay. Look at this. Remember, exercise is your medicine. Remember, must take your medicine if you are taking your medication, right? So for those of you, remember, especially for those of you who has cancer, especially during this time of puasa, right? Then you need to take your medication. You need to take your medication because your health, right, is very important. Don't until, you don't want to take your medication and then you have gastric. And that's where sometimes all those things are the ones that actually, affect your health. You know, instead of getting better, you get worse. Alright, so look after your health first, okay? By taking your medication well. Now, for those of you with IBS and GERD, okay? Irritable bowel syndrome or gastroenteritis, okay? This is a very trying time, especially in Ramadan. I will share a link as well for those of you who wants to know more about GERD and IBS. And again, you have to look at that issue of yours. Handle that one, and then at the same time, then you handle your weight loss things, okay? So remember, health first. take your medication to control your health, okay, to control your medical problems, and then exercise as your medicine. Okay, food is your pharmacy. Remember, looking at your plate, all right, that will be your macronutrients, your micronutrients, all your nutrients will be there. That's your pharmacy. Okay, you don't go to you always go pharmacy, go and take medication, right? That your food is your pharmacy, yeah. And then it's all mental. That's what I'm going to share in my Tuesday of the few days following sebelum Hari Raya. Okay, everybody. Okay, everybody. So again, for this one, I want you to come very closer together here. Okay. As a way of yeah. All right, I want you to take a look at this. This is very important. Okay, look at the core. It's back to basics, everybody. Yeah. Okay. This is my last few slides already. All right. This is a core. Just a reminder. A core. Okay. Back to basics. Okay, everyone. Back to basics. Always remember reset button. Back to basics. And then eat and exercise for strength. All right. Eat and exercise for strength. And then endurance is what you need so you can run the distance, okay? It's not only for short term. It's not only for weight loss for this 1 month for Hari Raya or something. It's for your whole lifetime, all right? And then run the distance, okay? Endurance, you need to run the distance, okay? In terms of your food intake, in terms of your exercise, okay? You need to run the distance. Consistency is the efficiency, okay? Is the one, okay? And then flexibility, okay? Is listen to your body, all right. So everybody, all right. It's flexibility. It's listen to your body. You know, sometimes when we are tired, we need to listen to our body. Okay, we do not want to bully our body. Never use that word bully when you take care of yourselves. Okay, so that is very, very important, everyone. Now take a look at this, everyone. Obstacles will be all you see when you take your eyes off your goals. Right. Remember, what is your main objective? What is your main goal? All right. Obstacles will be all you see. Okay, when you take your eyes off your goal, never think about the 10 or 20 kilo you want to lose. Think about your first 500 grams you want to lose the healthy way. And then it will pave the way for easier weight loss. And remember, always remember back to basic. This is so, so important. Commitment to health. When you're committed to health, okay, all your weight loss and every other thing trying to get well from your medical conditions will come in naturally. Okay, everyone? All right, I want you to take a look at this tomorrow, everyone, 3 p.m. 3 p.m. Tomorrow here. Okay, stay at home, sweat with Dr. D. This was last week. All right, I will share some more photographs of you guys exercising, myself exercising. All right, we will have lots of fun. Remember to have your dumbbells ready. All right, have your towel. And then for those of you who's not fasting, have your water. And then you can also put your stretch band by your side. So maybe I'll show you a couple of things that we can do with the stretch band. Okay, everyone? All right. So, this is my contact number, everyone. Alright, just take a look at that. I'm just going to say, Dear Yusof. Hello, Dear Yusof. Oh, yeah. Wow. That's very true. Okay, very, very true. Okay, and then don't forget this one. Okay, everyone. Okay, come take a look at me. Okay, everybody. It is so wonderful. I've seen a lot of things here. Okay, Wawa said, okay, not only for health, okay, for sanity. That's true, especially when you stay at home, right? At home, nothing to do, exercise, okay, exercise, but never mind, some of us has exercised, some of us have not exercised, but some of us also have not exercised regularly. Remember, consistency, regular, okay, that's your two main thing as well. And again, don't look it lah, okay, when you look after your food, okay, you are doing good things to yourself, okay, not that I'm saying that, wow, this bulan puasa cannot eat everything. You can eat all the nice things that you want. Okay, I know some of the foods are really naughty foods, but that's fine. But always remember that, okay, at one sitting you eat a lot of fat food. Remember that every other sitting, when you sit for your meals, make sure it's good and healthy food. And remember, hydrate well, okay? Drink well, okay? Everybody? Alright, I want you, okay? Okay, and yes, Abang Jari prefer coffee than others. You know that? Coffee is a good weight management tool as well. There you go. So drink that as well. And then, everyone. Oh, yeah, Zia, that's true, right? Theory lesson we did 4 years ago. But there's a lot of additional and new things that's happening. And that's why I say, knowledge is very, very important, yeah? And then again, everyone, okay, tell me if there's anything else you want me to answer. Okay, especially on stress management and beauty that's coming up. Alright, and then again, I want you to be aware that on the, let me see, tomorrow, I'll tell you more, more exciting things tomorrow. And then again, I want to thank everyone, okay, for watching this one. And this is very important. These are all important knowledge, right? So I hope that you guys can share it on your Facebook, on your social media, on your WhatsApp, so that anybody who, you know, sometimes there's more people out there, okay, who doesn't know what we learned today. So it will help them. And the more you know, we share, the more they'll be healthy, and the more we will be helping the community of the world. And you know, right, the more community, the more happier are the community, the more happy we are, because we'll be in a more positive, hashtag positivity, right, Nat? Right? So everybody, I want to thank you very much for your time, you know. So I know you got to prepare for Ramadan Iftar, right? So go ahead and do it. Okay, and remember, okay, you are the one. Okay, because you're cooking, and because the husband who's listening to this, because you are the head of the household, okay, affect your influence your family towards good health and towards a happy, healthy lifestyle. Okay, thank you everybody. I love you guys. Okay, drop me a note if you like it. Okay, and then after that, tell me what you want to hear. I will answer everybody later on. Okay, thank you everybody. I love you. Bye 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 bye. Selamat berbuka.